What's up, JD aliens? Yeah, that's right. I called you a JD alien. Look, if you're a subscriber to this channel and you like watching these videos, consider yourself a JD alien. Just accept it. Anyways, man, I wanted to talk to y'all today because I think I got a problem. Well, it's kind of like a fetish.
Let's do it.
So the first step to realize you have a problem is acceptance that you got a problem. I have developed this new fetish slash problem of hoarding like camera equipment, cameras, and lighting equipment. I love it. So I don't know if you noticed today, but my lighting is on point. Like, it's banging right now. I don't know how it was yesterday, but today my lighting is on point. And that's because my good friends over at IVISII have provided me, they played into my fetish. They provided me with this 3 LED light paneling system I got here. So I only got one here right now on the table because I'm using 2 of them right now. Like, this is one and this is one. The LED ring light that I'm using is right. It's actually my camera's mounted in the light. I reviewed that a couple of weeks ago and I love that light. I actually sold my other 2 that I was using and I just kept this one. And that thing is awesome. And I love it because it works in conjunction with everything else, which I'm about to show you. So calm down, hold on to your britches. So what we got here, like I said, it's a 3 light kit. And it's these LED flat panels. They look like this and they're very, very slim and sleek. And I wanna show you some details about these things that I really, really like. Now, once again, keep in mind that all these lights work in conjunction with each other should you pair them up using the optional remote. But let's get into this first. So first of all, you get this stand, which is pretty much a basic stand. It's got a little bit of branding right there and it goes up to about 6.5 feet. And it's pretty lightweight. It's pretty versatile. And it doesn't take up too much room as far as the tripod goes, or the tripod section of it goes. But let's put that to the side. You also get, this is a strap, because I noticed when you plug in the AC outlet on the back here, because that's your DC in right there. Because what I noticed is sometimes if you have the stand all the way up, like to 6.5 feet, this right here, this little transformer deal right here, it's actually gonna be hanging and you really don't want that hanging from the plug right here. So what you would do is you just kind of strap that around the pole and that'll give it some more security. That way it's not just pulling on this DC plug right here, because you don't want to have that fraying and stuff like that. So that's what that's provided for. So it does come with that. Next thing it comes with is the panel itself. And it also has this swivel head right here. So you can actually have it mounted like I've got it mounted here. So these two are actually mounted on the poles and I just have them tilted down to provide my lighting. Okay, so as you can see here, there's 2 battery slots. If you opt for it, you can shop around, get some Sony batteries. These are not actually Sony official batteries. These are some knockoffs right here, but you can get you 2 batteries and you put them in here. Let's go ahead and do it. Let's just put them in there right there. Now you can see right here that that's the plug power. So if you're using the plug, that DC adapter, just click it on the power right there. But since I'm using the batteries, I will turn it on that side. And what you see right here, you see that glow? It's like an underglow. So you see that glow? Right now, what you're looking at is, can you see that LCD display? You got 50% of light brightness, and then you got your Kelvins right here, and that's the hue of your light. And then you have all these different channels, A, B, C, D, E, F, and there is no G. And then you have channels, which goes up to, I don't know, let's just see. Let's see how many channels it goes up to. Wow, okay, it's getting up there. Is it? Tell me it's not. Okay, 48 channels. There you go. 48 channels. And the reason why is because you can have each one of these lights on its own individual channel, or you can have them in groups. You can pair them up or mix and match them any way you want to. So I have 4 lights here. And what happens is if you get the optional remote, you can actually control all the lights by themselves or each light individually. Or if you only have 1 light, you can just control 1 light with this if you wanted to, or you can have a system going like I've got. So what you're gonna notice is this light is actually on right now using battery power, but as soon as I turn this on, it's gonna be on its own separate channel. In fact, let me just go ahead and make sure it is on channel 3, okay? It is effectively on channel 3. And it's in group A, which doesn't matter because it's on a separate channel than the rest of it. Now my ring light that you're looking at right now is on channel 1, group A. Now these lights right here are on channel 2, group A. So they're on 3 different channels, but watch when I turn on this remote. So right now I'm at 50% brightness at 5400 Kelvin with my ring light. So if I switch channels, which I'm doing right now, I'm on channel 2, group A, that is these lights up here. So if I start, oh, did you see that? So now I'm actually controlling my upper lights, my down firing lights. Oh man, that is super bright. Golly, okay. That's like solar flare bright. So let me take that down a notch because I had it at 25%. It also has quick settings right here. So, and that's on the back of here as well. So now what I'll do is I'll put that back at 25% because I don't want to annoy you guys. And then I will go over to channel 3. So now we're locked into channel 3. Well, now I'm going to flip this over that way. Oh my God, can you see that? That's so bright. Oh, this is going to be difficult. Okay. Now I got light on top of light on top of light. That is so serious. Okay, so right now, I'm gonna bring it down a notch. So right now we're at 1% brightness. We're on channel 3, by the way. I'm at 1% brightness at 5400 Kelvin. So let me bring it up a notch and then I will actually change the Kelvin and I'll bring it down to a nice amber light. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, now it's kind of a bright sunlight or a bluish color, and now we get down to a more warmer tone. So let me go ahead and take this back to, oh wow, all the way up to 8,000 Kelvin, good Lord. Okay, oh, I'm gonna go blind doing this video. So let me take it back to 5,400 Kelvin, and let me take this down to 1% because now I'm effectively blind. That is ridiculous. Okay, let me turn this back over. You see how easy this is for me to manipulate? This thing is so lightweight and thin. So the batteries are actually kind of heavy themselves, but the panel is actually pretty thin. So taking you back to the lights linked up with each other on different channels and groups, let's go ahead and play around with some stuff. That way you can see the full effect of this bad boy. So right now I'm actually using the ring light in front of me to light up my face. Isn't that face handsome? All right, so let's put some more light on this handsome face. Right now, let me go ahead and change it back to group one. I'm sorry, channel one, group A. Let me turn up this ring light. Oh my God, hold on. Okay, so now the light is dim. And this is so nice to have if you're a videographer shooting yourself or shooting anything and you need that convenience of a remote control. I didn't realize how big of a deal this was up until this stuff came into my life and I was like, wow, my life is so much easier now. Now I can brighten things up and go blind anytime I feel like it. Let me take it back down to 50%. And then let me go over to channel 2. And I'll go ahead and start toying around with my downfiring lights again. See how that, oh man, that is so awesome. I feel like I'm in a tanning bed. Not that I need it or anything like that. Let me turn this back down to 25%. Let me use these quick settings. Right here, we have the quick setting button. So right now we're at 1%, 25%, and 50, and then 100%. Let me go ahead and take it all the way down to 25, and there it is right there. So let me take it back over to channel 1. Let's turn this dial to channel 1. Lock it in place. Now channel 1 is at 50% and I'm ready to close out this video. Now look, I know I got all this gear here and it might look professional and stuff, but I'm no expert in this kind of stuff. I just got a problem, man. I really love videography and I love the lighting stuff and I love the camera gear. But if you had a good time checking out this new lighting system with me, you go ahead and throw those emoji hands up in the comment section and I'll see y'all at the next one. All right, apparently you had a good time watching this video. Well, today is your lucky day because I done already made a whole bunch of them for you to go back and binge watch. But if you just want to check out the new stuff, you make sure you smash on that subscribe button and tap that little bell. That way you'll know when it's time to come back and open up some new stuff.